Okay. Let's do it. Let's talk spoilers. What do we have here? We have a movie where Lex Luthor finds kryptonite, and he's going to use that to weaponize it, and so he can have it in case he wants to kill Superman and Batman. He already knows who Batman is. He already knows who Superman is. And his long-term goal for the last years, ever since the alien invasion, is to pit those two against each other, use Batman to kill Superman or Superman to kill Batman, and then I don't know what. I don't know what beyond that. I just know that that was his plot. And he has set it up so that Batman hates Superman, basically thinks that Superman's been taunting him, sets it up so that Superman looks like he's killed, like, did this mass shooting in Nairobi, and that he blew up the Senate. He blew up the Senate, I think, because the senator refused to allow him a bill that would allow him to transport kryptonite into the U.S., so he has to do it illegally. Then he gets pissed and blows up the Senate and also frames Superman for it. Wonder Woman, for some reason, is trying to find an old photo of herself, and maybe she's nostalgic. I don't know. She hasn't been in the superhero business for a while. The Flash breaks through the time barrier, warns Batman of a Superman gone crazy, says that Lois is the key, and we get Lex Luthor using the alien spacecraft to merge his DNA with General Zod and create Doomsday. He can't control Doomsday. Doomsday goes up against Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman. Superman sacrifices himself. They have this awesome fight. And then there's the death of Superman. So, the tonality of this film is fucking all over the place. It's all over the place. It starts off with the death of Superman's parents, all right? And this is one of those things where you're just like, why are we doing this again? Why are we doing this again? And the very important thing to remember, if you go see this movie, the reason why they're setting up the death of Batman's parents again is for one reason only. It's so that we establish that his mother's name is Martha, okay? That's like the most important thing. I feel like the film should have just started off with the flashback to Metropolis during the General Zod Superman fight from Man of Steel, and it should have started there showing like Batman's perspective. But they went back and did this, you know, this intro from the past scene showing him falling into the hole with a bunch of bats and all that stuff. And I just was sort of like, why are we doing this again? And then it comes to that, you know, I came to that conclusion where I was like, ah, they need to establish his mom's name was Martha. But like I said in the spoiler-free version of this review, it is seriously all over the place. I mean, literally 1 minute we're in one scene, the next minute we're in the other. I have these notes here, right? I have all these notes when I took in the movie. And most of them are just me going from like different portions of the movie from the other. It's just sort of like trying to keep up with everything. There's like a fight club scene. Then you go to the newsroom. You go to Lex's office, Wayne's Manor. Then you have a dream sequence. You have the lake house. Then you're in Lois in a bathroom. And then you have Alexander Luthor doing his thing. And then they go to the fundraising party. And then they have Neil deGrasse Tyson. I mean, like, seriously, it is all over the place. Like, this movie has no cohesiveness whatsoever, and that is just, oh, that's like one of the things that for the first three quarters of the film I was just like, oh, this is just, I'm not having it. This is really cheap, lazy writing, and I hate it. And it's just trying to tell all this stuff, and I don't know why. They literally could have just jumped to Justice League and we all would have been happy. We would have been just effing happy. But he really wanted to set up this Batman v Superman thing, and this is where I'm gonna get like really annoyed, all right? Okay. Lex Luthor is a smart guy. He's supposed to be super smart. I've said that in the spoiler-free version. He would not create Doomsday if he didn't think he could control Doomsday. He wouldn't carelessly and recklessly just pit this version of a psycho monster up against everyone without deliberation. He actually, in his mind, is supposed to think he's doing what's best. If you watch Daredevil, there's a character named Wilson Fisk, also known as the Kingpin. In his mind, he's a smart guy. He thinks he's doing what is best for everyone. He thinks he's making the city better. And that's exactly what Lex Luthor normally does. He thinks he's doing what's best for everyone. He thinks Superman is scum, that he thinks he's better than everyone, he's an egomaniac, and that he is power unchecked, right? In many ways, the Batman you see in this film is what Lex Luthor is supposed to have. That's his psychosis. That's supposed to be his psychosis, that if a man can be this strong, this powerful, he must be checked. He must be stopped. We must destroy him, or we must somehow have the ability to stop him, because we don't know. We as humans should actually be in control, and we can't allow an entity that has that much power to dominate us if it wanted to. And I think that very much like is in vain with what Lex Luthor normally goes through. Wilson Fisk is the Lex Luthor we all deserve, but we didn't get. But we got him in Daredevil. So anyways, we get this campy, ridiculous Mark Zuckerberg version of Lex Luthor's son. And there's this scene where he's walking to the crash site and this funky music starts to play and he's walking into the crash site and it's just like, it goes from a tone of like, you know, crazy doom and destruction and despair into this like hooky little version of him walking to the crash site trying to get into the ship. And then we have another scene where he's like literally popping a cherry Jolly Rancher into a guy's mouth. And I was just sort of like, none of this makes sense to me. What does all this mean? Are these Easter eggs? Am I missing something here? And then we jump to a Batman and Superman that we, in my opinion, it's just really hard to know them. This is a Batman that kills, fine. We already have a Superman that kills, might as well have a Batman that kills too. Vehicular manslaughter, yay, let's go. But you have both of them doing heroic things, or supposedly heroic things in this movie. You have Superman saving a bunch of people from a flood and a fire. You have Batman saving a group of women from a sexual slave trade. And yet there's no hope in it. I don't feel hopeful when they do these things. I feel like it's so gritty, it's so tragic, it's so depressing, and you're just sort of like, ugh, like, there's not that moment where you're just like, Superman saves the day, yay! It's more like, Superman saves the day, the world sucks, it's all going to hell in a handbasket. And you're just like, ugh, okay. I was like, even those moments, you could have at least gotten a little bit of uplifting joy from it, and I didn't get that from this film. Another really huge shortcoming, I think, was the fact that, again, Zack Snyder just kept borrowing elements from the comic books. You know, he borrowed elements from Doomsday, he borrowed elements from Injustice, Gods Among Us, the game, he borrowed elements from The Dark Knight Rises, and yet he just didn't get it. He just didn't grab at the actual heart of those stories and then take it. He just borrowed elements from it, so they had no soul to them. There's a whole nightmare sequence that keeps continuing within this entire movie, in which Batman is seeing a version of the future in which Superman has gone ballistic, has gone fucking like fascist ballistic, destroying everyone. He's full of hatred, he's full of fear, he has like become the Darth Vader of our world. And there's really no, we know this as, you know, if you're into comics, you kind of understand where this is coming from, what elements are drawing from. A little bit of, you know, Injustice, where Lois Lane, he's tricked into murdering Lois Lane, goes fucking ballistic on the Joker and becomes insane, right? And that element is borrowed, right? So this version, this apocalyptic version of Superman in which Lois has been killed or someone else. But I'm not sure how the general population is supposed to, you know, the general moviegoer, how are they supposed to know this? You know, like, it's not explained. It's just, it's in there kind of like this Easter egg, but it's never really explained. As well as, like, the things like the Flash coming in. The Flash comes in, and it's supposed to be, well, a lot of people came out of it thinking it was a dream sequence, but it's actually not. It's the Flash coming in, breaking through the time barrier, as he does in the Flashpoint Paradox, a great animated series. But, again, How is a general moviegoer supposed to know this? They won't. It's very confusing. In fact, I was sitting next to Zixa, and he was just like, when the Flash came in, he was like, who is that? And I was like, that's the Flash. And he's like, what? And yes, it's a post-apocalyptic version of the Flash, but who's going to know that? It's just so poorly done, you know, and it's not explained. It's just in there. It's all just lazy, lazy writing. And I think the most indicative of that is when you look at like how they introduced the other Justice League members, okay? Fucking 5 megabyte MPEG files. I shit you not. It's like Batman loads up this computer, a bunch of files he got encrypted off of, decrypted from Lex Luthor, and there's these metahuman files, and you have Wonder Woman, and you have Cyborg, and you have Aquaman, and you have The Flash, and it's like all laid out in like beautiful little folders, and then you just double click on each one, and you see a little bit of an intro story of each one of them, and you're just sort of like, oh yay, Wonder Woman, there's a picture of her from 1918. Ah, there's Cyborg. His dad's building him, and he's back there all RoboCop style, and there's a mother box, which is not even explained, that turns him into Cyborg. And I don't even think they explain that that's his father, which it may not be in this version, but still, it just, you're going to go ahead and go that route, might as well just explain that as well. And then you've got Aquaman being a merman in the sea, and you're just sort of like, a lot of people are just going to be like, what am I seeing? You know, this, it's again, drawing little elements from all the comic books, putting them in, but not giving them a cohesive story. And then The Flash, I don't know what I saw there. It was just sort of like, how was anybody supposed to know that was The Flash, right? Like, if you didn't know, if you just didn't know. Like, the scene where he's in this convenience store and the clerk is being robbed, and you see a little jolt in the security frame footage, and it's just sort of like, boop, that's it. That's The Flash. You're like, oh, okay, well, there's your Justice League, guys. Let's go. We can just edit these MPEG files together, and there we have a Justice League movie. And I'm not even going to talk about the fucking Jonathan Kent scene on the mountain with his horse, his dead drowning horse story. What the fuck was that? I don't even know. Whatever. Let's skip that. Okay, so let's just go on to the parts where I found, like, super just, can't. Batman v Superman. All right, taken from The Dark Knight Rises, element just dragged that element out of Frank Miller's comic book work. Fine, all right, but didn't give it any background, didn't give it any emphasis or meaning or weight to it. Batman is completely manipulated by Lex Luthor into hating Superman, and Superman is blackmailed by Lex Luthor because he kidnaps his mom and sends him after Batman, saying, "If you don't kill him, I'm going to kill your mom." Why doesn't he just go rescue his own mom? I don't know. So here we have the fight of the century, Batman v Superman. In this iteration, there's actually no reason for him to hate Superman. There really isn't. There's 2 years worth of Superman's deeds and 2 years worth of investigative, you know, detective work that Batman could have done, where he could have figured out that he doesn't hate Superman. All right. So I don't know. That just felt so forced. And one of the biggest things that really just nailed it in was when they're fighting to the death and Batman's about to fucking kill Superman, and Superman's like, "Save Martha." He's like, "What did you say?" He said, "Save Martha." It's like, "Why did you say Martha? Why did you save Martha?" And then it's just sort of like, "Because that's his mom's name." And then it's like, "Oh wait, your mom's name is Martha? My mom's name is Martha too. Let's be best friends. Yeah. Okay. We're friends. Sweet. We're bros. Let's go kill Doomsday. All right. Things are good now. We're the Justice League." That was written into the story, guys. I shit you not. Fucking both their mom's name is Martha, and so now they're best friends. Did I miss something here? All right. There's some good redeeming qualities with the fight scenes with Wonder Woman, Batman, and Superman. I liked all those. There's a couple plot holes where Batman ends up dragging Doomsday back into the city because he's trying to drag Doomsday back to the spear he had created with Kryptonite to kill Superman instead of just taking the spear to Doomsday. You know, a couple $100 million worth of property. It needs to be damaged, but anyways. Okay, so let's get on to the worst of it all. I think one of the reasons why I'm the most unhinged by this movie. Okay, I did a review, or I did a rant that I originally titled called "The Murder on the Murder of Superman." I swear I did not know that this was going to happen in the movie. Okay, I did not know the death of Superman was coming. I didn't think they were going to go there. You know, Zack Snyder metaphorically had murdered Superman to me in Man of Steel. In Batman v Superman, he physically fucking murders him. This is one of the worst fucking stories ever, right? This is one of the most manipulative things to ever happen in comic book history, right? The death of Superman. And yet, that's what Zack Snyder takes and puts into this movie. And you're just sort of like, why would you do that? You have Batman solo movies coming out. You have Cyborg, you have The Flash, you have Aquaman, you have Wonder Woman, you have fucking Justice League coming out. Why on earth would you take one of the most manipulative, shallow things that could have ever happened in comic book history and bring it onto the big screen? The death of Superman is a manipulation of the masses, all right? It was to make it seem like we could kill a hero. We could do that, you know, Game of Thrones style, you know? We will kill someone you love, and we mean business. But then there was the return of Superman, which we all know is coming. In fact, at the end of this movie, all the audience knows it's coming. Thus, you have destroyed the meaning of death within the DC universe. You have... Anyways, Max Landis does a really amazing, amazing video on this. I will link it down below. He says everything that I need to say about the death of Superman, and I am floored that they did that. I mean, there's this moment where, you know, Martha comes in and she gives Lois this ring and said, Clark meant to give this to you. And, you know, you're just sort of like, oh, he was gonna marry her, but now he's dead. But he's not. He's fucking not dead. So it's just, it's cheap. It's so cheap. And just, I didn't want to dislike this movie, okay? I did come away with a couple great things about this movie. I liked Wonder Woman. I didn't think I was going to, but I did like her. I liked Ben Affleck as Batman. I didn't think I was going to do that. And I really loved, and I really loved seeing them come together and fight together. I thought that was very well done. And I'm very much looking forward to a Justice League, even despite this movie. I'm looking forward to a Batman solo movie. So it's just sort of like, I didn't come out hating this movie, but I hated the elements. I hated so many elements. If it weren't for the fact that this was Wonder Woman, if it wasn't for the fact that this was Superman and Batman, I would hate this movie. But I don't hate this movie because I still love those guys. I want to love them. I think a lot of people want to love them. And Zack Snyder and David Goyer just didn't give anyone a chance to do that. And I feel like it's sad. It's really sad. All right, thanks if you finished watching this, kudos to you. I really appreciate you hanging in there and listening to me rant. I really want to have a discussion about this. If you really liked it, if you have issues with what I said, I'd love to hear it in a really, you know, in a reasonable manner, right? You know, I'm not going to really pay attention to anyone who just bashes me, but I definitely want to have a discussion. If you have a different opinion, let me know. Let me know your opinions in the comments and we'll talk about it. All right. If you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my Daredevil Episode 9 review, or you can click right here and watch my Game of Thrones trailer review. Until next time, see you guys on the flip side.
Taking constant care not to break something, to break someone. Never allowing myself to lose control, even for a moment, or someone could die.